If you work full-time, chances are that your business operates on a 5-day work week. For folks in the US, this usually means that for 5 days out of the week, they are putting in 8 hours of work. In recent years, people have started to challenge the traditional work week, claiming that people should be allowed to put in fewer hours for the same pay. What are the arguments for this? Could the future of the workforce involve less work? These are big questions, and fortunately, there is data that we can look at to get a picture of whether or not this would work. But first, let's start with where the 5-day work week came from. In the early 1900s, workers became fed up with working an average of 60 hours a week. In the United States, unions formed and began to demand a more lenient schedule so that they could have more time off and spend that time doing the things that made them happy. In the 1920s, Henry Ford implemented a 5-day work week. Now, he didn't do this out of love for his employees. He knew that productivity would increase as employees were happier, and that sales would increase if people had more time off that could be spent shopping. And he was right. After World War II, American consumerism boomed. It was seen as patriotic to purchase good old American goods. By this time, businesses across the nation had adopted a 2-day weekend. Some people thought that this trend of a decreasingly strict work schedule would continue. In 1965, a subcommittee of the United States Senate claimed that Americans would be working on a 14-hour work week by the year 2000. Obviously, they missed the mark by quite a bit, but their reasoning wasn't so silly. As technology has improved, more and more of our daily tasks have been performed by robots, or at least made simpler and faster through the help of advanced technologies and equipment. As this happened, there were two realistic possibilities. Either workers would complete their daily tasks more quickly and would be allowed to go home, resulting in fewer hours worked, or they would simply complete more tasks to fill out their full workday. You might think that the second option is clearly what has happened, but the reality is that nearly 45% of the time we spend at work goes to waste. Getting paid for wasting time may raise some ethical flags for some people. But the important thing to remember is that being productive 100% of the time is not possible, and even if it were possible, it is incredibly unhealthy for your body. One study reported that people who work over 55 hours per week are 13% more likely to have a heart attack and are 33% more likely to suffer a stroke than people who work 35 to 40 hours per week. Alongside the physical damage caused from working 100% of the time, your brain endures higher stress levels and you're more prone to develop unhealthy eating habits. With these things in mind, some groups are revisiting the mindset of those union strikers from the 1900s, calling for the work week to be reduced to 4 days. More specifically, many groups want a 3-day weekend. This may sound like a radical idea at first, but it might actually be better for business. A 2015 study showed that participants were roughly 10% more productive when they were given treats or were allowed to listen to comedy clips before performing tasks, and were less productive when they were told to think about things that made them unhappy. Simply put, there is evidence that suggests that workers' happiness is directly correlated to their productivity. As technology evolves to minimize the mundaneness of our daily tasks, perhaps it's time we start prioritizing spending the free time being happier. We've heard the expression, work smart, not hard. Now, it may be time to do exactly this. For businesses, the smartest move may be to let technology serve its ultimate purpose, making the lives of humans easier. Chances are, they'll be rewarded for it in the long run.